Hey guys, and welcome back to another vlog in the life of me, a graphic designer no longer in training because she's a graduated boy. So as you would all be aware, it's been a hot minute since I filmed or posted anything for a few reasons. The first reason being when I was still studying graphic design and I was in those final 2 weeks of finalizing my portfolio at Shillington, I didn't have the capacity to be filming and editing on the side of trying to put a portfolio together because it was literally taking every spare moment of my time to get it right and get it done on time. Then after I graduated, I felt that I needed to take a little bit of a break and kind of just transition and adjust into my old life. I went back to full-time work and was trying to do freelance on the side of that, and it proved to be very difficult. It still is very difficult, and so I just needed to kind of figure that out, wrap my head around it, try and get into a routine and time manage myself a little bit better so that I could figure out when I had time to film and do all of these things. And the third reason being that in doing so and taking the time to just kind of settle back into my old life, I kind of settled into a little bit of a rut at the same time, and it's been really tough. I have been procrastinating filming for a really long time. I didn't want to do it. I was kind of feeling like a little bit of a failure as well, but I am trying my best to get out of it and get back into creative routine and to be constantly making things so that I can pursue the things that I want to pursue. Proving a little bit difficult at the moment, but it's all right. And I want to document my experience of putting a portfolio together. So without further ado, here is week 12 and 13 of Shillington College. So week 12 of Graphic Design College started with a win on the Monday when I got my first brief signed off. So if you'll be so kind to remember back to my previous vlog, you'll recall that I was in the midst of working on redoing a whole magazine spread, like overhauling it completely, because this is what I started with and this is what I finished with. So these were the inside spreads. As you can see, they're very different from the first ones that I had, and then this was the front cover, and I'm very, very happy with how it turned out. I think it definitely represented the brief a little bit more, as they were trying to go for this whole like non-conformist vibe, but was still illustrating this magazine's value of being rebellious and set apart from the normal travel magazine industry. That same day, I started to look at the rollout for my Mumbai project, because I knew that that was a big one. It required a lot of effort, considering that it was an overhaul, as this was the initial poster that I came up with in the previous weeks leading up to portfolio, and I hated it. It didn't fit the brief at all. It was horrendous. But leading up to portfolio, we had a chance to do a website for that same brief, and so I came up with this, which was a way better direction for Mumbai. I think it better fit the brief a whole lot better, actually met the brand values and concepts of Mumbai. Like, they are a cultural epicenter, they're full of so much life, and so I think that that was definitely a lot better fit. And so I had to come up with the rollout for that entire project to go into my portfolio, and so I needed to put a lot of thought into how that whole design style would be applied to posters and different things that could represent that brand. And so that's what I continued to work on Monday. Got the nod from my lecturers that I was going in the right direction with that. And that was Monday. On the Tuesday, I revisited my OTEP annual report, which I was really happy with from the beginning of doing that brief, and so there was very little adjustments that I had to make in order to get that into my portfolio. I think I only made minor refinements to some of the typesetting and then some of the image positioning. I did add also another spread entirely, so that was something that had to go through the lectures again to get approved. But yeah, most of Tuesday was taken up with just making it perfect in order for it to go into portfolio and just nitpicking. On that same day, I started to also work on my Dish app, which was a cooking app. I was mostly happy with my app design, but my lecturers did ask me to rethink the color palette entirely because the 6 projects that had been picked to go in my portfolio had a recurring pastel color palette. So I obviously was trying to show that I could do a range of different things. All of Wednesday, I literally went back and forth with my lecturers about different color palettes that I could use. This was the initial app color palette that I had. I really liked it because I felt like it fit the brief really well and it fit the identity of the brand that I was trying to represent, but it was just very difficult. I felt like every color palette I went through really just changed the whole feel of the app. I ended up just writing that one off. I wasn't gonna try and revisit it on that day because I just needed a break. So I started working on my BFI Film Festival brochure, which was, if you remember, I had to do like a campaign event for John Hughes Film Festival. So that was really fun. I was going with the whole 80s aesthetic. And so the rest of Wednesday, I was just like, I'm gonna get the Dish app out of my head and just focus on that. So I did some just like research rollout, trying to figure out how I could apply my design style to different things like tickets and popcorn and stuff like that for the film festival. On the Thursday, thank God, I finally got my Dish app design signed off. I came up with this color palette. It's still friggin' pastel, but I literally was just struggling so much with anything else that fit the brief, and so that's what I came up with. I don't know if I like it any better than the first color palette, but it is what it is. And I changed a couple of the different app modules as well and just how it was set out, just because I felt like I could make it better in a way. So that was the entirety of the Dish app signed off in my portfolio. Good to go. I also continued to work on my BFI Film Festival rollout that day, and also decided to rework my Unity Music Festival illustrations. If you'll remember back to my last vlog again, you'll remember that I did illustrations for the Unity Music Festival in Illustrator on my computer because we just had limited time restraints, and so I was just doing it on that. But I decided that when the time came that I could work on it in Portfolio Week, I was going to do the illustrations on my iPad in Procreate, and so that's what I did. I was just reworking them, making them look more professional in a way, better than what Illustrator could do, and they were just turning out a lot nicer, so I was going in a different direction with that one. Again, just doing some more work on it and also reworking the poster design because that was changing too. On the Friday, I continued to work on my Unity Music Festival poster so that I could get that signed off and then I would have the go-ahead for the rest of my rollout. That was my goal for Friday, just to get the poster signed off so that they were happy with me to go on to tote bags and tickets and all of that stuff. But after lunch, my hard drive decided to absolutely cark it. I don't know what happened, but it just stopped working. I couldn't do anything. I was literally just sitting at my computer for like an hour trying to figure it out, and then my lectures were just like, just go home. But I got home and everything was fine. It was for some reason just the college computers that couldn't handle like my hard drive capacity or something. I don't know. Tech was weird. It was whack that day. But Friday night, I just continued to look for different applications that I could roll out my designs onto. So I was just looking for like popcorn mock-ups and stuff like that that I could roll out my designs onto. That weekend was super busy as I was trying to pretty much get all of my initial applications done so that I could get them finalized and approved on the Monday, because we only had like one or two days in that next upcoming week to actually get all of the designs approved so that we could then move on to portfolio layout and like distribution of all of the designs and then actually making a website to put our portfolio on. And just like there was so much more to do that week, so really our designs had to be done in the first next 2 days of week 13. So I was like doing the mad dash over the weekend to try and get everything done so I could get it approved and I could focus on other things. So yeah, it was super busy, super hectic, but moving on to week 13, the final week of my graphic design course. So on the Monday, I finally got my BFI Film Festival all signed off. So I was really happy with how it turned out. You'll see that I had the brochure and I had tickets and popcorn that all kind of fit the same theme of this film festival that was in honor of John Hughes, and I was really stoked with how it turned out because I'm obsessed with the 80s, so I was really happy. And I also got my Mumbai project approved, so that was a huge rollout. It was the first one that was going in my portfolio, so yeah, everything from logo to postcards to billboards to poster rollouts, like you name it, I had it all. I probably will want to expand on that rollout a little bit more. I wanted to do like a travel brochure or like go-cards for the city, like that type of thing, just to, yeah, apply the design to different mediums would be really cool. So yeah, I think I'll revisit that one just to see what else I can do with it. But that was the Monday, and on the Tuesday, I finally got my Unity Music Festival all signed off and all of its applications and rollouts so that it was ready for my portfolio. So I was really happy with that and how it turned out actually, because I wasn't too sure in the beginning of how it was going to work on different applications like tote bags and stuff like that. I just wasn't sure if it was going to be too repetitive and annoying, but it actually turned out really well and I'm really happy with it. And then for the rest of the day, I continued to work on my portfolio layout and how all of my designs fit into whatever order and how I wanted the experience of looking through my portfolio to be. On the Wednesday, I finished all of my different mock-ups as I was just nitpicking all of them and trying to make them perfect for my portfolio. So finished all of those, also finished the complete layout of my portfolio, got that signed off by my lecturers. They were happy with how that looked. And then I started to work on the layout of my website. I just went through Adobe Portfolio because it's super easy, as like if you upload any of your work to Adobe Behance and like that profile, which is, side note, incredible. So many people can discover your work through that way. But if you upload it to Behance, it automatically translates straight to your website and uploads there. So we were just finalizing the layout of our websites, doing all that stuff. And then Thursday was uploading all of my projects to Behance so they could go on my website, and just making sure the website was perfect, making sure the portfolio was perfect, and just making sure I was happy with every little thing so that I was proud of myself. And that brings us to Friday, grad day, super surreal. That morning we had mock interviews with some of the like part-time lecturers and people from the industry coming in to give us a little taste of what an interview would be like if you were to show someone your portfolio and tell them what you're capable of doing and how you came up with your ideas and why you chose that color palette, why you chose that typeface, like all of that stuff. It's so important and it's so necessary to know. So we got to practice on people from the industry, which was incredible. I'm so happy that they did that for us. And so I felt like mine went really well. I got really good feedback. It was just really incredible to have like a fresh eye look at your work and be like, wow, like that's really good. And I was like, thank you. Like, because you just get so in the mindset of thinking that your work sucks because you've just looked at it for way too long and you just like pull it apart, think it's so bad. So to have a fresh eye and to have someone be like, no, this is genuinely good, you're like, okay. Thank you for validating me. It's a good time. So I'm really glad that that happened. It gave me that little extra self-confidence boost for the showcase that was to happen that night. But before that happened, we had like a little mini graduation ceremony. We got our certificates that showed that we were graphic designers. Super cool. It was really nice. Headed home for the day, and we went to our showcase that night. And so everyone had all of their portfolios out, whether that was print or digital. People from the industry, past students, people that were interested in maybe becoming students, just anyone and everyone came and looked at these portfolios, which was so cool to watch someone look at your work and kind of get to see the impact that it had on them. It was a super fun night. It was so lovely to be able to say goodbye to everyone. I met some really incredible people during this course and I'm gonna miss them greatly, but it was an incredible experience. I don't regret it for a second. If you're thinking about doing some sort of graphic design college or even Shillington College, I would highly recommend it. One of the best decisions I have ever made, and it has taught me so much. And I'm so happy with the portfolio that I had to take out of it. And that was the Friday. And then on the weekend, I was packing up my room in the place that I was staying in Brisbane, and I moved back to the Gold Coast. So here I am back in my old room, just settling back into my life, I guess. But yeah, I'm really excited to try and pursue a design career now. I really need to get back into the habit of just doing design for fun. That's it. Thank you for coming along on this journey with me. Thank you for being patient with me and listening to me ramble and listening to me worry about everything and anything. And yeah, it's been a great experience. Thanks for coming along on it with me. You can expect more to come in the future with other different projects, but that finishes the vlog series, I guess you could say. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Or you can hit the bell notification to stay in the loop. That's gross. I hate saying that. What is YouTube? Anyway, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.